Positron emission tomography is a diagnostic method where we use radio tracer for measuring various metabolic processes in the body. The most common radio tracer is fluorine-18-fluorodeoxyglucose, which is a glucose analog which gets picked up by cells instead of regular glucose. The logic is that after the intake of radio tracer, cells begin to consume radio tracer. And with consumption, radio tracer begin to accumulate in the tissues. And basically, by PET CT, we can determine the difference in amount of radio tracer between the various tissues. So we can say which tissue consumes more glucose and which tissue consumes less glucose. And areas with the higher metabolic activity that consume more glucose have a brighter, more intense color on PET CT. So to explain the mechanism of this diagnostic method, here we have cells and also we have blood vessel that delivers nutrients to these cells. When we inject radio tracer, blood flow delivers radio tracer among all other nutrients. When nutrients are delivered to the cells, cells begin to uptake glucose from the circulation. And if cells are the same, they uptake glucose in the same speed. So let's suppose that every cell in the tissue uptakes 2 glucose molecules. So normal distribution of radio tracer results in approximately identical brightness of tissue on PET CT. But we have a certain disorders that can affect normal glucose metabolism by the tissues. First of all, it's the conditions that cause increase in glucose uptake by certain tissues. The most important one is cancer, because cancer cells consume glucose by the Warburg effect. So let's suppose that one of these cells becomes malignant. Cancer cells, due to anaerobic glycolysis, consume glucose faster than any other cell. So while malignant cell consumes 6 glucose molecules, normal cells in the same time period consume just 1 glucose molecule. So in the end, the distribution of radio tracer will be completely abnormal, because there are a lot of glucose in malignant cell and only a small amount of glucose in normal cells. And on PET CT, we can see a very bright color of cancer tissue and just mild intensity in normal tissues. So there is a real-life PET CT in patient with cancer. On first image, we can see that the intensity of the right side of the neck is substantially higher than intensity from the left side. It turns out that the reason is proliferation of cancer cells. On next image, we can see the same area but in different projections. On this image, we can determine an area of high intensity in the liver. And it turns out that the reason is hepatic metastasis. On next two images, we can see the same hepatic metastasis, but in different projections. On this image, we can compare CT with PET CT in patient with a lung cancer. As we see on CT, it's not that clear whether cancer cells are present or not. But if we use radio tracer in PET CT, now the presence of cancer cells becomes very clear. The next condition that can cause increase in glucose intake is inflammation. If inflammation develops, white blood cells come into the tissue, and white blood cells naturally consume a lot of glucose. So the higher the amount of white blood cells in the tissue, the higher the glucose uptake by inflamed tissue. So now inflamed tissue consumes 6 glucose molecules, while other tissues consume just 1 glucose molecule. So inflammation also causes abnormal distribution of glucose, and we can determine this on PET CT. There is PET CT in patients with giant cell arteritis. The hallmark of giant cell arteritis is inflammation of temporal artery. Here we can see that temporal arteries have very high intensity, and the reason is severe inflammation. Also, vasculitis affects branches of temporary artery. We can see that they also have very high intensity. In this case, inflammation is so severe that inflammation spreads even to occipital arteries and vertebral arteries, we can see that they also have increased intensity. And as we know, the higher the intensity, the more severe is the inflammation. On this image, we can see areas of high intensity across the aorta, subclavian and axillary arteries. And in color, we can see areas of high intensity in thoracic aorta and in axillary arteries. As we see, there is quite a severe inflammation. On this image, we can see high intensity in subclavian arteries. In this case, such intensity is caused by severe inflammation. Also, on PET CT, we can determine decrease in glucose uptake that can be caused by thrombosis or occlusion. To explain this, recall that blood flow is directly proportional to the pressure difference and inversely proportional to the resistance. And the resistance is inversely proportional to the force power of radius. So if thrombus is formed, the radius of the vessel decreases. If thrombus causes decrease in radius, resistance will increase, and with increase in resistance, blood flow decreases. With decrease in blood flow, nutrients delivery decreases, so the lower is the amount of available glucose for cells. As a result, instead of two glucose molecules, cells can consume just one. And on PET CT, we can determine low intensity of color, which means that in this region, there is decrease in metabolic activity of the cells.